Call this meeting of the Fremont County Board of Commissioners to order. Would you please rise and join me in a pledge of allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Roll call.
Commissioner Norden?
Present.
Commissioner Payne?
Present.
Commissioner Bell?
Present.
County Clerk Barr?
Present.
County Attorney Jackson?
Present.
County Manager Bryant?
Present.
Planning and Zoning Director Cope?
Present.
Just some procedural notes before we get started. Well, first of all, let's get the agenda approved and then I'll go over those procedural notes.
Mr. Chair, I move to approve today's agenda as presented.
Second.
Motion and a second to adopt today's agenda as presented. Any discussion? Roll call.
Commissioner Bell?
Aye.
Commissioner Payne?
Aye.
Commissioner Norden?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Today's agenda covers basically five items, the last item being a request for renewal and a modification. Just to note that the commissioners have received some written comment on some of these applications. Those are part of the record that we have in front of us today. There is going to be, since items 1, 2, 3, and 4 on the agenda are for renewals, they are not subject to a public hearing. The only item on today's agenda subject to a public hearing will be the request for modification for Pure Medical. The last item, which the public hearing is scheduled for 9:30, so hopefully we'll be able to stay on track and get that started on time. Item number one under new business will be OPC 14-007. This is an optional premises renewal application for Pure Intentions Wellness at 685 Highway 115. Sharing some of the space on the former Biker Town property in Penrose. Representing the applicant, or the applicant is Jared Doy. Mr. Doy, good morning. How are you today?
Good, how are you doing?
Okay,
good
you
morning.
Want to make any comments on your application for renewal?
I believe that we've complied with everything as prescribed by your body, and that we've gone through every effort to remain a good citizen within the community and not make too many waves.
Okay. Mr. Cope?
All right. Application was made for renewal. All the application items were submitted. The only outstanding items for consideration would be proof that the property taxes are paid and up to date on that, as well as a current copy of the state OPC license when you get that, or if you have it, get it to our office. Code enforcement has not received any written complaints on this site. They did do a field inspection and found no violations. There have been no concerns. We did receive a letter from the sheriff's deputy, Mr. Burton, in regards to this site. There were no complaints filed with the sheriff's department, only some minor alarm issues, and I believe those have been taken care of as well. So all in all, this is a clean renewal.
All right, any questions of Mr. Koch or of Mr. Doy?
I have a question for Mr. Doy. Could you talk just a little bit about those alarms and let us know how that problem has been resolved?
We were having an issue with mice that we did not realize, and they were walking across our motion sensors. So we've put mice mitigation processes in place.
Mouse mitigation.
Yeah.
That's a new one for this board. And the fix seems to be working?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Use peanut butter?
Exactly.
All right. Any other questions for Mr. Doyle?
No further questions, but I do have a motion.
Please.
I move to approve C3 Colorado Springs LLC optional premises cultivation commercial greenhouse 2016 renewal for OPC 14-007.
With
the proof of tax paid and with proof of state license.
State license. Okay. Second.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Motion and a second to approve renewal of Pure Intentions Wellness for OPC 14-007 with the requirements as noted. Any other discussion? Roll call.
Commissioner Bell?
Aye.
Commissioner Payne?
Aye.
Commissioner Norton?
Aye.
Motion carries.
And I'm going to give my thank you, sir.
Thank you.
I'm going to give myself time because these applications were voluminous, and the department scanned those electronically. So,
bear with the two middle-aged guys.
Yeah, as we open these up so that they're in front of us on our screens here. All right, next item will be consideration of OPC 14-009, Golden Meds, operating by Edward Vasquez at 890 7th Street in Penrose on the west side of I at the intersection of 7th and I in the Beaver Park area. Good morning, Mr. Vasquez.
Good morning.
And you want to give us an overview of what has happened at that site or not happened?
Since the last time we were here, we've completed our odor mitigation plan as it was written up. Largely that is vegetative barriers to hopefully create a better smell and counteract any smell that we are producing. We also have carbon filters installed in our processing and storage areas. I think that will be the most effective means of mitigation. We also have directional barriers on all our output fans to try and direct the airflow, one, back onto our property, and two, down towards the ground to keep away from our neighbors. We have blackout systems installed. I know we have had one incident where we had a mechanical failure one night, and one area of a range did not close properly. We did receive a complaint on that. We addressed it the next morning. You know, it's unfortunate it was a mechanical error, but we were absolutely diligent, and we will remain diligent to fix those kind of issues.
Can you give us an overview of how many greenhouses are on site, and from the time the permit was actually issued, how much time did you operate? Are you in operation now, and in how many facilities are you operating? Give us an overview of your operation.
Absolutely. We have two large greenhouse buildings, so to speak, that is comprised about 32,000 square feet of floor space. We have then several cold frame hoop houses, which are essentially just a metal curved frame with a piece of plastic draped over the top. We have seven of those. Those are not currently in operation. We are in operation about 2,000 square feet in one range currently.
In one range. Okay.
In one of the large houses. We've been in operation for about a month. Previous to that, we were not in medical marijuana cultivation. Most of last year, we actually did hemp marijuana cultivation, which is largely identical, except the regulation is different. During that time, two of those ranges were largely filled with hemp marijuana. We did not receive any odor complaints during that time. And aside from the one incident where we had a light complaint from the mechanical failure, we didn't have any other light complaints, to my knowledge.
So what you call a range is a greenhouse, is that right?
Is a large greenhouse building. It's got 8-foot sidewalls, and then okay. It's, you know, got a roof. And one range is, I want to want to say about 15,000 square feet, and the other range is slightly less than that, I think around 12,000 or 10,000 square feet.
So, I'm still confused. You said 32,000 on the two greenhouses?
On the two greenhouse buildings.
Buildings.
And then we have...
Within that is the range of, is that right?
No, that would be the same as a range. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Confusing you. Two greenhouse buildings, and then we have seven cold frame hoop houses on the property as well.
Okay. So you say you've been in operation for about a month on marijuana?
On medical marijuana, correct.
Okay, and you mentioned a complaint about odor, and that occurred when you were growing hemp or marijuana, medical marijuana?
We had a complaint, a light complaint, and that was when we were doing hemp marijuana. We have not received any odor complaints to this time. And the smell is largely identical. We have also taken the advice from planning and zoning. They said they've had some pretty good success with some of the misting systems that some facilities have put in. I've reached out to two companies. They're working on bids to put those in as well. We are in compliance as we were written up. We've been 100% in compliance, but we are looking for better ways to maintain the smell and any issues that we have.
All right, so you talked about what has happened in the past year. What are your plans moving forward? Are there other greenhouses or ranges that are not in operation that will be put into operation, or are you occupying all of your space?
Right now we're occupying the total floor space of plant production is about 2,000 square feet right now. So it's very small. These are small plants. They're only a month old. We intend to utilize largely most of the space that's there. And there's about 52,000 total square feet of production on the whole property.
And so what are your plans of staging and ramping up production?
We are currently ramping up production. I would say we'll probably be 6 months before we are fully in production.
And what steps then, because you said you've completed odor mitigation plan, carbon filters, and the processing storage areas. That includes odor mitigation in those areas that you plan to fill in the coming 6 months? Or?
I have the hoop houses are not going to be in use until maybe into the winter. Right now they do have some vegetative buffers, and actually right now they have ornamental flowers inside of them. So they're probably mitigating the smell more than creating any sort of issue. Once I get these bids back for an actual misting system, those will be attached to the hoop frames as well, yes.
To the hoop ones?
Yes, to all ranges, correct.
So you'll be going from 2,000 square feet to, did you say 50,000?
52.
That's about correct, yes.
Okay. All right, go ahead.
That is historically what we've occupied throughout our existence. We've occupied about 52,000 square feet.
All right. And those premises were all existing when originally licensed?
Yes, correct.
Okay.
We have not modified any of the facilities.
Okay. Any other questions for Mr. Vasquez?
Not at this time.
No.
Department report?
All right. The applicant did make application for renewal. All items were provided except for the two contingency items. Code enforcement did do an inspection of the property and found it to be in compliance with the application. They did see all the flowers out there too. They were very pretty. The two items that are still outstanding would be a copy of the renewed center license, and then we need the current dates of the occupational licenses to make sure they are valid. So we just need copies of those. We did have complaints, as was stated, regarding light, and those were closed and corrected. Prior to licensing, there were complaints of odor, and those have been taken care of through the odor mitigation as well. So everything has been corrected since licensing. So other than that, we have no comments.
Okay, any questions, Mr. Cope?
I do have a question or two for Mr. Vasquez now.
Okay.
You talked about the night that part of your lighting barrier failed. Was there someone actually present at that time?
No, there was not. This was late night. We were unaware of it until the next morning.
So the system is completely automated and it closes itself according to a timer, or
exactly.
Is that correct?
Yes, they're set on timers to open and close. They are mechanical timers. They're industrial mechanical timers, but you know, mechanical systems sometimes need maintenance and you know, sometimes fall apart and catch you off guard.
So what time are they set to close and then to reopen again?
Right now, I believe they're set to close. I want to say it's about 6 o'clock. It's well before dusk. I do have lights on in one of those ranges. I've had them on for the past month and a half. So they are working. They are effective.
That's on your two large greenhouses? Is that
yes,
right?
Yes, correct.
Okay. Sorry.
They are effective. You know, they are working. They are set to open. I believe they open at basically daybreak because at that point the light turns off and we use natural light again.
Okay. And I just want to make sure that I understand what you're saying. So when you talk about the hoop houses, you said that they will have mist odor mitigation installed?
Yes, they will.
Okay. And that's the only kind of odor mitigation that they will have, correct?
We have the vegetative barriers as we do around our other ranges.
Mm-hmm.
Essentially, better smelling plants that try and capture the odor and hold that and prevent it from leaking out onto the adjacent properties. We're going to continue to do a lot of vegetative barrier stuff in the upcoming months. It's been winter and it's been hard to plant a lot of those things. But now that we're in spring, we're actively planting more and more all across the property.
Such okay. as?
Lavender, sage. Right now I have 6,000 square feet filled with annual and perennial flowers. So the smell there is actually very pleasant, unless you have allergies. The whole facility is sort of a wreck on you.
So are you familiar with other operations that vegetative barriers have proven successful?
I would say they are successful at mitigating odors. I believe the misting systems are successful at mitigating odors as well. Has anybody found a cure-all means to prevent the odors? I've never seen one. I've never heard of one. I've certainly asked to other facilities. I've asked planning and zoning to review other applications and tell me what they think was working best so that I can copy that and follow it.
Okay. Any other questions for either staff or Mr. Vasquez?
But it's possible to put the carbon filters on the hoop houses, is that correct? If you need more odor mitigation?
I can put them in there. The way the system of cooling that we use is a passive cooling system. It's the cool wall, essentially a swamp cooler. So you're taking outside air, passing it through a wet wall, and then pushing it through the house. It's very hard to completely contain a passive cooling system. It's somewhat near impossible. About the best you can do is spray the air as it comes out the output fans. If we had an air conditioning system, if we were an inside system, you know, we would have a closed system and we would be, our job would be easier. We do the absolute best we can, and I think we really are not only in compliance, but absolutely striving above and beyond that to do anything we can to help out.
Okay, anything else?
I don't think so.
All right, I'll make a motion to approve renewal for OPC 14-009 for Golden Meds. With the contingencies listed, and I think you've already stated, Mr. Vasquez, of trying to work over and above to be vigilant. I think you know what the issues are as much as anybody when it comes to odor, and I think that's the concern of this board and this chairman in making the motion that in asking those questions about how large it's going to expand, as you noted, in 6 months before full production, that it's the full expectation of this board that we not get a series of complaints.
Absolutely.
Okay. I need a second.
Second.
Motion and a second to approve OPC 14-009 for Golden Meds. Any other discussion? Roll call.
Commissioner Norton?
Aye.
Commissioner Payne?
Aye.
Commissioner Bell?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Thank you. Item number three, Maggie's Farm LLC, OPC 14-010. Bill Conkling or Allison Longshore?
Good morning. I'm Allison Longshore.
Good morning. This is for property located at 4211 Fremont County Road 84, on the north side of County Road 84, basically south of Rockville.
Yes.
You want to give us an overview?
I'm actually going to have my colleague, Niels Heider. He works at the farm premises, and he can speak in length and detail about the premises.
And state your name again.
Niels Heider.
Okay. And would you fill out one of those slips so that the clerk has a spelling of your name, please?
Yes.
And you can do that after you through speaking. Okay, go ahead.
We are asking for a continuance of our license at 4211. We have submitted one change that was a fencing change, and we're told that we did not need to submit that, and we are just continuing as we have been doing business in the past.
All right, any questions for the applicant?
Not at this time.
Not this time.
Matt.
All right. The applicant did make application for renewal. All items were submitted except for the last two contingencies. The site was inspected by code enforcement and found to be in compliance with the application. We have not received any complaints on this site. Howard did give us a letter, Howard Burton, stating that everything was fine, and again, all they had were some alarms, I guess, at one of the areas out there, from what he said, but that's been corrected.
Yes, it has.
Okay. The two contingency items are a copy of the current state OPC license and answering to the environmental health officer in his letter, and I believe you've taken care of that.
Yes, we have.
Okay, and so we have received a letter from Sid saying everything is good to go on that end. Other than that, that's all we have.
And I have submitted the OPC licenses to Donna this week. I believe you're right for that as well.
It's been submitted?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Any questions of Matt?
No.
Questions of the applicant?
I just have a little bit of a question, I guess, with three separate 911 hang-up calls that have come from that property. Have you ever been able to track down who those were or why?
No, we haven't. We have called the alarm company, that we have panic buttons on the site, that it's just a small button that goes immediately to our alarm system, so it's, you know, for the safety of everybody. Sometimes those buttons can get pushed, and that's the only thing that we figured. We have actually purchased new buttons, so that doesn't occur. It now runs through a cycling system before that goes immediately to the 911 dispatch.
So have you had any issues since you purchased those new buttons?
No, we have not.
Okay.
Okay. Could it be mice?
I don't think they compress those.
We could point you in the direction of mouse mitigation.
I heard that, yes. So I'll be looking into that. Thank you.
All right.
No further questions.
Chair will entertain a motion.
Okay, I've got a motion for you. Mr. Chair, move to approve OPC 14-010 Maggie's Farm for LLC for optional premises cultivation with that one contingency with the Colorado State license, which has been submitted.
It has been submitted, so I'll second that.
Motion and second to to approve renewal for OPC 14-010 for Maggie's Farm. Other discussion? Roll call.
Commissioner Payne?
Aye.
Commissioner Bell?
Aye.
Commissioner Norton?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next item under new business is consideration of...
they're still up here, right?
Yeah, that's... Are we next for this one? Mm-hmm. Virtual marketing?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
It's the same applicant.
Oh, okay.
It's for this.
Yes, okay, for the virtual marketing.
Yes.
For the,
this
yes.
is for a store.
I'm sorry.
No, you're fine.
Yes, this is
we
for...
We draw a picture.
Virtual marketing. I didn't understand what you were commenting on. This is for the storefront for virtual marketing doing medical marijuana center pharmacy. And
correct.
That is located in the Country Green Shop at 3555 East Highway 50 in Canyon City. And any comments on that operation?
No, I think we've been in operation there for a number of years and continue to prove our compliance and as an upstanding business as part of the community.
Okay, any questions for Ms. Longshore?
Not this time?
No.
Department report?
All right, again, they did make submittal for renewal. All application items were submitted. There was no outstanding items for consideration. The code enforcement did do a review and found that the site to be in compliance with the application. And there are no other concerns.
Okay. Any other questions of Matt or the applicant?
No.
No, I have nothing. I do have a motion.
Okay.
I move to approve MMC 14-004 Virtual Marketing LLC for a medical marijuana center renewal.
Second.
Motion and second to approve renewal of virtual marketing medical marijuana center pharmacy at the Country Green Shop at. Any other discussion? Roll call.
Commissioner Bell?
Aye.
Commissioner Payne?
Aye.
Commissioner Norton?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We have a minute before 9:30, but I'm going to go ahead and do the renewal. Okay. By the way, if you want to comment as part of this public hearing, if you will fill out a slip that's on the back table, and I've already got a couple of people who want to speak on the record for the modification. We will consider the renewal first and then open the public hearing for the modification. So I will consider renewal for OPC 14-001 Pure Medical LLC operating at 448th Street in Penrose, just east of D Street in the Penrose area. Jason Vanstrom is the applicant.
Hi, I'm Carly Van Adam. Nice to meet Jason Vanstrom today.
Okay.
I'm James Marks. I'm the...
All right, and if both of you could also fill out one of those slips, and you don't have to do it now, but when we're through, if you could fill out one of those slips and hand it to the clerk so she knows who's speaking. Okay, for the renewal portion, you want to give us an overview of your operation and your application for renewal?
Being accepted, and we've been operational at that location since 2000. year.
Excuse me, can you move a little closer to the mic? Thank you very much.
Sorry. Did you get all that? Do I need to repeat anything?
Yeah, okay.
We've just remained compliant since 2013, so there hasn't really been any changes.
Okay, any questions of the applicant at this point?
Not this time.
Nope.
Matt?
All right, again, they have submitted the application for renewal. They have submitted all items. As far as the renewal is, there is no outstanding contingency items for that. Code enforcement did do a site review and found it in compliance with the application. In this instance, we did receive complaints, verbal complaints regarding odor as well as some fencing concerns. The odor wasn't determinable because of the nature of the area, and some of the complaints were actually filed when you weren't growing, and so it was considered to be maybe be associated with another grow in the area. The fence was found to be unfounded because of the nature of the fencing that was in concern. So all in all, there have been no written complaints, and the verbals were found to be unfounded or no evidence towards them. So other than that, that's all we have.
Okay. All right, questions of Matt?
No.
I don't think so.
And give us an overview of what the odor controls that you have.
Currently, it is an outdoor facility, so
oh, they're outdoor. Yes, okay. Okay. Status of renewal for a motion.
I'll make a motion that for the renewal of OPC 14-011. Is that correct? Yeah. Pure Medical LLC. Make a motion that we approve that.
Second.
Motion and a second for renewal of OPC 14-001 for Pure Medical. Any other discussion? Roll call.
Commissioner Payne?
Aye.
Commissioner Bell?
Aye.
Commissioner Norton?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Now, the hour having reached 9:32, I will open a public hearing on a request for modification from OPC 14-001. And would you give us an explanation of what your modification application involves?
Yes. So it's kind of two-part. The first part is some unfinished business from last year when we submitted the original application. There was a bit of a miscommunication stemmed from two factors. We thought that when we applied for the grow, we were applying for the OPC to be able to utilize the entire space within the fenced area for growing. However, at that meeting in May that JR attended, it seemed that there was a little bit of miscommunication and that we were only asking for approval to grow underneath the canopy. Again, the miscommunication stemmed from two factors. The first was that there was no designation on the local application about indoor, outdoor, greenhouse, or otherwise. So when we applied for the OPC, again, we thought we were just applying for it as a whole. And the second is the state definition of a limited access area. A limited access area is defined as being able to be used for cultivation, harvesting, or storage. So the diagram that was submitted showed a greenhouse as well as an outdoor grow area. So again, we weren't sure why we were only approved to grow underneath the canopy. The second part of the modification is new. We are requesting permission to put up a 1,200 square foot building for the purpose of harvesting and storage. It will help us remain in compliance with the state law. It will be an odor mitigated building, so that should help with any odors due to the process of harvesting and the flowering plants. It should also add some more security during the harvest time.
Any questions of the applicant at this point?
I do have a couple of questions for you.
Sure.
First, if there were so many miscommunications last year, I would like to know, when did you or someone else from your operation come in and talk to planning and zoning about this and say, yeah, we have a problem, this is not what we thought we were looking for?
Sure. Actually, the first sign of really a miscommunication was at the meeting on the docket, because many of the grows on the docket were listed as, can you, everybody hear me okay? They're being listed as outdoor grows, and we noticed ours was listed as a greenhouse grow, when in fact it was an outdoor with a canopy structure. It's not a complete greenhouse. It is a CO'd structure, however. So really, when we submitted the application back in September, all the way up to May for the hearing, we were not aware that we were only applying to grow underneath the canopy. The day of the hearing was kind of when we found out. JR was the representative at that hearing. He wasn't really sure how to go about resolving it that day, since the meeting was already underway. So after the meeting, we called planning and zoning and said, hey, there's been a miscommunication. We didn't realize we were only allowed to grow under the canopy. The intent was to grow in the outdoor area as marked on the diagram. How do we fix this? And it was determined at that time by planning and zoning that the best thing to do would to be to submit a modification of premise. Now, the reason we haven't done that until just recently was because we were waiting on the CO for the structure, because the department wouldn't accept a modification of premise application until that CO was completed. And that CO wasn't completed until just, I believe it was February or March.
A CO on what, I'm sorry?
On the canopy structure over one part of the OPC.
Okay.
So since it was just approved a couple months ago, it was determined by planning and zoning that it would be the most economic use of time to roll that modification into this renewal hearing. And that's why it's been about a full year that it's been like this. Last year, we only grew under the canopy structure knowing that we were going to be having this meeting at some point to hopefully get the approval to use the entire limited access area as denoted on the diagram.
Okay, I also have a question for you about the harvest room.
Yes.
How is harvesting currently done if you don't have an indoor place to do this?
The harvesting is actually done at the building that is on the diagram, the barn, and that's the reason we have everything is fenced off, is so that we can move plants from the canopy structure to the harvesting barn, and with a visual block. And that's why we went with an 8-foot tall fence. You know, a lot of these other greenhouses are going with 6-foot. We went with 8-foot just to give us that much more privacy and, you know, that much more security for the whole community. You know, we don't want to look vulnerable. And that's where it was kind of taking place. That's what we utilized before.
At the end of the harvest last year, we determined that barn is not really suitable for the process that we need for harvesting, which is why this spring we added the request for that 1,200 square foot building.
Okay, thank you.
What is your, how are you going to do your odor mitigation on the harvest room? What's your plan there?
We have two steps. The charcoal filters is going to be one, and then also in the same ductwork as that, which will be the air being evacuated out of the building. There will be air ionizers and UV light filters, which the one I'm looking at will condition up to 100,000 square foot building. So we're going definitely with a lot of overkill to help burden all that stuff.
100,000 square foot building, you're building a 1,200 square, yeah. That's good overkill though.
It's a lot of overkill.
Yeah. Then what is your plans for the barn then that was the harvest room?
The old, you're talking about the old facility.
Yeah.
Mainly it's probably going to be for keeping moms, which are vegetative plants that never go into flower. They're just used to clone and propagate more plants off of, so they don't produce a smell. And mainly just hold the DVR systems, because that's where we already have them all set up and things like that.
Okay.
Mainly like a workshop. We're just going to be pretty much converted.
All right, thank you.
So absent this new building, where have you been doing the trimming and processing working?
Well, since we only harvest once a year, it only takes place in that one building for the or even underneath the canopy structure, depending on how big of a crew we have there. So that's why we're applying for bigger buildings.
Okay, so in the past year, that trimming and processing lasted for how long?
About 35 days.
And that was done outdoors?
Partially outdoors, and then, partially in that.
Okay. And if you get, if you build this structure, are you, it'll be again about the same 35-day period?
Yes.
Okay.
We're looking to, you know, we'll either increase our staff, but we have pretty much about that big of a window to harvest our crop before it freezes.
Okay. Any other questions for the applicant at this point?
Not at this time.
All right, Matt?
All right, the application for modification was submitted. All items were submitted. They did have two outstanding items that we requested and that they did fulfill. That was pertaining to the fire and law enforcement notifications, as well as the letter from Pennhills Water District, and we have gotten those taken care of. The two outstanding items that would fall on the modification would be a letter from a design engineer that the odor mitigation system was installed to design and operating. The other one would be a certificate of completion from the building department for the new building. So those would be the two outstanding items before licensing could be get granted for that. We did receive many comments on this. They should be part of your files from the public. Majority of them were stating that they are against the additional odor and concerns of that. Looking back at the original application file, the file did show the fenced area the way they do have it now, showing that the intention was to use that whole area at that time. So there was a misrepresentation from somewhere regarding that in the original application. So,
if I may, I know that some of that miscommunication comes on my behalf. It was one of my first board meetings I've ever been in, so I didn't want to overstep my boundaries, so I figured I was supposed to just explain the canopy structure, kind of. And I didn't know if we'd taken all the steps proper to do things, and I just, you know, that was one of the reasons for some of the miscommunication here.
And I had actually completed the application and submitted everything with planning and zoning, but I was out of town for that hearing at that time, and that's why I wasn't here. And then as soon as we got back, we called and determined that this was the best way to handle the situation.
Okay. This is a public hearing. I have three written requests to speak. If anyone else wants to address the board on this modification request, you can fill out a slip and hand it to the clerk. Tony Glyforst.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
Hi, my name is Tony Glyforce. I live at 485 G Street in Penrose. I have some concerns here. When is enough enough? Last time I checked, the moratorium was still in effect. What part of no new construction and or modifications is not understood? It seems to me that this industry will not or cannot accept no as an answer. Just like children playing adults against each other, they're playing the county residents against the county commissioners. And this is the OPC license 14011. The question is, how can they mitigate odor from an outdoor grow, which is part of our ordinances that you guys made? What about the light mitigation if they use a lot of light? Also, is this a residential zoning building, or is this a commercial zoning for this operation? Another question for all involved, not just the growers, not just the manufacturers or the residents, but it stems to the state, says that all, let's see, how did I say this, that all of the products, the plants, the soils, the water runoff, and clippings are considered hazardous waste. I can't recall seeing any hazardous waste containers or vendors removing hazardous waste in the area, anywhere in Penrose. My concerns are not just for the county residents or the businesses, but it's also about the preservation of the area. When is enough enough? I understand that you don't want to make anybody's licenses more valuable than the next guy's, but it's just like a guy I heard on the radio this morning saying, it's same as the liquor licenses. Do we need these on every corner in a residential neighborhood? Let's be real. Thank you.
Thank you. Clarice Roney.
My name's Clarice Roney, and I live at 856 D Street in Penrose. I live across the street from this grow. I am opposed to it. It already has smelled in the past when they were growing, and if they increase the size of it, it's going to be worse. I sit about halfway between the 8th Street grow and the C Street grow. I'm getting it both directions. It gets really unbearable at times, and each of these growers points the finger at the other one. And again, like Tony says, enough is enough. We shouldn't have to bear this burden. Thank you.
Thank you. Charles Campbell.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hello, my name is Charles Campbell. This is Sonny D'Andrea. We live at 428th Street, directly next door to the property in question. when we first moved in a year ago, we knew, of course, who our neighbors would be, and we were very curious as to how that would work. Would it stink? Would there be bright lights all the time? Would it be noisy? That sort of thing. So the first year, we paid attention. And to tell you the truth, we couldn't tell. I never smelled a pot plant. I never saw a pot plant. It's dark at night, and the loudest thing over there are their roosters. So as far as I'm concerned, they are pretty much the ideal neighbors. And if every grow in Penrose followed their example, I think that maybe people would have fewer issues with it. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you. Those are the three slips that I have to speak. Others that want to address the board during this public hearing? All right, seeing none, I will close the public hearing, noting that the board, as Mr. Koch has already indicated, has in front of us the record of written comments that have been submitted over the last couple of weeks on this particular modification application. And I'm sure that we have reviewed, though I know that I've reviewed the letters again this morning. It's the board's desire. Do you want to hear anything else from the applicant?
I'd be curious to know if they had any reaction to anything that was just said by anyone else.
I would like to comment on the gentleman that was talking about the waste, just because I don't know if that may be a concern for you. They do deem it a medical waste, is so that it's not being thrown out in the garbage and kids can come by and pick it up. We have to properly shred and dispose of it. We can then later mulch it and put it back into our soils and compost and things like that, and that is deemed safe. They're basically just labeling it hazard material, like I said, so that it just doesn't get put out into the public where anybody can just come pick it up and freely use it. We need to basically, you know, destroy it before it's ever placed in a dumpster or recycle it back into.
So how do you do that?
I compost.
All of it?
Yes.
And keep it there on your own property?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
So we've received several letters over the past few days after the public hearing went out into the paper, and so we have tried to address many of those. The first underlying concern in all the letters was odor. Now, in 3 years, with the exception of the one complaint in January that was found to be unsubstantiated, we have never received a formal complaint about odor. And if this is approved, we intend to keep it that way. We don't expect that once we get approval that the community is just stuck with it. We will do everything that we can to ensure that we continue to not receive complaints for odors. The harvest building will help mitigate a lot of those odors because a lot of them are during harvest time. That's when the plants are at full flower, where they emit the most odor. So by cutting those down and bringing them into a odor mitigated building versus harvesting them outside, we hope will alleviate a lot of those concerns. And also, we have brainstormed some different options, although it's not required for an outdoor grow, on how to mitigate that if it does become a problem. We don't just intend to, you know, after we get approval, you know, do whatever we want. We want to continue to be upstanding members of the community, and we want to continue to set the benchmark for marijuana grows in Penrose.
So to help me understand, going back to the back and forth on the confusion from the original application.
Mm-hmm.
So you've been growing under the canopy only as licensed?
Correct.
And give me an idea of how many plants you've been able to grow outdoors under the canopy as licensed versus how many plants you would have in the entire fenced area.
Last year we had around 300 plants that went to about full term. That greenhouse can probably support up to around 500. But I mean, ultimately we're probably looking at maxing out around 1,000 plants total for both the canopy and the outdoor, just because there's only so much I can harvest in a certain amount of time. You know, I can't, if I overproduce and then a frost comes, then we'll potentially lose our crop. So a lot of our production is also based off of how much we can harvest and how efficiently. So, as of right now, you know, our plant counts are looking right around 1,000.
And so, not familiar with marijuana, when you're growing outdoors and the plant starts to mature prior to harvest, how many days and weeks are we putting off of
odor?
Odor.
We pretty much probably start producing odor around the end of August, and we will pretty much be harvesting from the end of September, the last week in September, to the first week in November. So it's about 3 months, I would say, right around, a little less than that we will be producing an odor. And you know, some of the things that's taken us a while to get our CO for that canopy is we originally changed it from a full, complete greenhouse to fit into the community. I sit on a 2-inch main line in Penrose, so I can only pull so much water. If I was to run cooling walls for that greenhouse, they would have to upgrade the main and those types of things. And we're not looking to try and put that burden on the community. We're also not trying to use that kind of water. And when you have these greenhouse structures, you're intaking a large volume of air, charging it with smell, and then evacuating it out of the building. And we're not looking to do that. We don't want to just keep taking large volumes of air, charging it, and then putting it into the community. We'd much rather just let what smell is there either linger on our property and dissipate over a large area. So, but I mean, as far as these plants, I mean, you could grow 1,000 plants that only produce a pound, that are only a few feet tall, or you could grow, you could grow 50 plants that are as tall as trees and produce, you know, 100 pounds each. So it really comes down to about what we can harvest and manage harvesting for our production.
And the hope is with this new trim building with the odor mitigation system that as soon as they are in the smelliest time, we'll be chopping them down and bringing them into this odor mitigated building, so it just won't be out there permeating the entire space. And again, we have brainstormed ideas, so if the expansion does cause, you know, any more or less desirable odors, we've kind of come up with ways that we might be able to utilize some of these ionizers in the canopy structure by cooperating with the planning department and trying to figure that out if it becomes an issue. So we have thought of these things. We know that that's the underlying complaint in the community, and we don't intend to ignore it. We intend to address it because we've remained complaint-free for the most part the whole time we've been here, and we want to keep it that way.
So to respond to Clarice Roney's remarks that the hearing portion that she gets odors from both directions, that the producers point fingers at each other.
We have never tried to point the fingers. We understand that we will produce some smell, and that's why we've based our operations around not producing year-round. We're not trying to burden our neighbors with a year-round smell. We produce a smell for a small portion of the year, and the rest of the time,
as the planning director stated, there was only one complaint that we'd received, and it was during a time that we hadn't been growing at all, so there was no way for us to be producing odors, and that's the only time it's been brought to our attention. So if there's ever been an an issue up to this point. We have never been made aware about it. There's no complaints in the file. So, you know, unless there are complaints made, we just figure everything is fine.
Where are you with growing right now?
Where are we at?
Mm-hmm.
We have plants in vegetative state. So just small 1 gallon pots, plants produce no water.
Under your cover, right?
Right now, where you're utilizing the barn.
Okay, any other questions for the applicants? Chair will entertain a motion.
Well, Tony had some questions.
Well,
and maybe Matt can answer them on light, zoning, and maybe his take on the hazmat. Those three Tony brought up.
Those issues are pretty much reviewed by the state. The state will review those issues. As far as the odor mitigation, it isn't required since it is an outdoor grow, as well as the light. I believe you just use natural light. You don't have any lights in place. So none of that would fall under the Planning and Zoning Department.
Okay.
Yeah, our only lights that we have outside is a few floodlights that are turned on, just like anybody else has a high-pressure sodium on their property.
Also, as far as the waste goes, and the state does have some pretty cut-and-dry, strict standards when it comes to waste disposal, and we are compliant with all those state standards, so waste shouldn't be. It is mandated and regulated at the state level, so hopefully that puts anybody's mind at ease that is being regulated and isn't being oversaw by other regulators.
Okay.
And as for, you know, our hairship of the land, you know, I use a lot of soil amendments. I mix my soil, so we don't pump a lot of nutrients into the ground. We're not dumping large amounts of nutrients. It's all basically mixed into the soil, real nice compost, and then it all gets recycled.
Okay, thanks.
And just a procedural note, based on what was said during the hearing portion, this application for modification is appropriately before this board. The moratorium does not apply to existing licensees seeking modification.
I don't have a motion at this time, but I have a comment or two, I guess, that I would like to make. For the first time sitting on this bench, I am completely mystified. I had no idea, as a commissioner, that there were problems with your licensing last year. We have had many changes in our Planning and Zoning Department, including a change of directorship. And this does continue to all be new to all of us. I mean, as much as we've worked, as hard as we've struggled, trying to put regulations and rules into place and trying to be fair to all sides. I don't know. That's where I'm at right at this particular moment in time.
Anyone want to make a motion?
You guys have your constituents to answer to, and many people have either sent letters or spoken out against any expansion, but we want you to be able to feel good about approving it. Thus far, we have tried to set a high standard on how marijuana should be in Penrose County. We intend to keep it that way. JR and his colleague Alexa both live on the property, so they are members of the Penrose community. It's not like they drive here from another town, work all day, and then leave. They're here, they shop here, they live here, they eat here. So we're going to continue to try to fit in. And if there are any issues that come from this approval going forward, we intend to wholeheartedly fix anything that may come up. And hopefully nothing does. Hopefully we can continue what we've been doing without any major issues. But we don't intend to put any undue burden on the community, be that through security with the Sheriff's Department, odor, anything like that. We've always worked very closely with the Planning Department and handled any issues that have come forth. Very quickly.
Yeah, I usually come down here and speak face-to-face rather than on the phone if there are any issues or anything, just to make sure that they get resolved properly.
All right, well, let me pick up from where Commissioner Bell left off. Because partly what she would have wanted to say that she didn't say is that regardless of how you operate, your request for modification gets complicated because of the constant complaints we get about marijuana in the Penrose area. So regardless how you operate, quite frankly, this board is probably not anxious to expand operations. And Commissioner Bell's frustration is that we didn't know that there was that misstep a year ago in your application. And so when I sit here, and I guess maybe I'm a little mystified too, because the difference between 300 plants and 1,000 plants at maximum over a 8 to 12 week period may not be much difference from an odor standpoint.
No. And you know, it's not, I mean, like I said, I could grow plants as tall as trees, you know, 15 feet high, yielding 100 pounds, you know, and that'd be just one plant. You know, I mean, there's been people that have done that. And, you know, so it's, like I said, it's really all about, we're gonna produce about the same, you know, it's just allowing us
to utilize the whole area.
Part of my issue lies in the fact that I still continue to spend a lot of time in Penrose, and there have been times driving, walking, that I'm smacked in the face with the smell of marijuana. And I look around and I can't see a single marijuana producer. I can't prove where that scent is coming from. If I lived there and occasionally had this, I would be totally unhappy. I would not be happy about it. And yet, it becomes almost impossible to prove. Whose fault is it? Where is it coming from? The wind always blows in Penrose. It always blows. And the winds shift, the winds change, they swirl around out there. So I know we do an awful lot of talking about odor mitigation and how it's all being taken care of and there won't be any odors, but the fact remains, yes, there will be odors.
Yeah, we're gonna produce odors just as much as a dairy farm is gonna produce an odor, you know, like it's just inevitable, you know. Like I said, and that's where we have changed what our original plan for operations was from a continuous year-round cycle where you're harvesting constantly to only once a year. We've taken that into consideration as part of the community. That's why we did that.
So if this board was not inclined to grant an expansion of growing beyond the canopy, how would that affect your intentions of the storage and processing building?
Well,
we would still probably need because, like I said, we're trying to eliminate the largest part of our smell is harvest. That is when you're chopping the plants, all the oils are coming out of the plants, that's the stinkiest time. So we want a fully, properly odor-mitigated building. And that's what we're really here trying to get. That's the main goal of our modification, you know, and the outdoor, you know, is resolving that from last year.
When we made the application last year, the intent was to use that whole area, and that's how it's been. That's how the diagram was submitted. So again, this is just a process of hoping to clear up that miscommunication. And as he said, the building will help with any odor mitigation, and really from an odor standpoint, you know, if we're required to only grow under that canopy structure, then it's a matter of growing up versus out. So ultimately, there's going to be the same amount of marijuana produced in a season. So we don't anticipate drastic changes in any odor that we emit at this time from expanding out into that uncovered area.
Okay.
But I just do want to note that, that is the main goal of our odor mitigation, is to only produce a smell for a very short portion of the year in regards to the community.
Question for, I guess, legal staff. If this board decided to allow the entire fenced area for growing for 1 year and then reconsider the entire fenced area versus the canopy when renewal comes up in a year from now, is that appropriate, or are we locked into the entire fenced area?
No, I think you can reconsider it if you make it clear as part of the modification that it'll be reviewed at renewal.
Okay.
Need a motion?
Yeah.
Okay. I suppose somebody ought to make a motion. Okay, I'm going to make a motion that we deny the expansion of the grow area, but we approve the 1,200 square foot harvest room.
No second? Another motion?
No second. Motion dies for lack of a second.
I will make a separate motion. I move to approve the modification for the 1,200 square foot harvest room, believing that it actually will help mitigate the odors. And to also approve the additional outdoor grow, making it clear that this is a 1 year, basically a trial approval to see how we do.
Second.
Okay, motion and second. And just for my own edification, am I understanding what you're explaining, that if you didn't grow out, you would be growing up?
That is correct.
Okay. Any other discussion? Roll call.
Commissioner Bell?
Aye.
Commissioner Payne?
No.
Commissioner Norton?
Aye.
Motion carries.
Understanding that this is a 1 year trial period and how you affect yourselves with the neighborhood will be reviewed. Specifically, I think we want the department to make sure that that's clear when this application comes for renewal a year from now.
Absolutely.
Okay?
Thank you.
Thank you.
There being no further business to come before this board, we stand adjourned.